We'll see the next question here. It is this 47th question. The inner wall of the solar cooker is painted black because. This question is from sources of energy. We are dealing with solar energy here. So in a solar device like solar cooker, he is asking, why do we have to paint black color only inside that one? Then see the first option. It reflects light. See, if it would have reflected the light, the device will not work properly. So this option is not suitable. Next, absorbs more heat. Yes, compared to all other colors, black absorbs more heat rather than any other color. Next, prevents from rusting. Here we are focusing on the working of that solar device, not on the corrosion or the damage to that container. So we cannot go for this option. Painting is okay. Yes, painting prevents rusting, but the subject or the main aspect of asking this question is, why do we have to paint black color only? So this is not suitable. Next, converges solar radiations. Yes, this happens in solar cooker, but black paint is not responsible for that. The mirror placed there is responsible for converging the solar radiations. Hence, our option or our correct option will be, answer will be, absorbs more heat. Like this, you need to go through all the options, choose which is more suitable, which is more related to the concept. Then only you can tick the right answer. Next thing here, if it has asked about paint, then it can also ask about the mirror in the solar cooker or the different parts of the solar cooker. What kind of device is it? What is the phenomena that is being used here? Or if not like that, which energy is being used here, or what kind of energy conversion is observed in case of solar devices? Such questions may appear. Next. The function of electric generator is, this we have studied in magnetic effect of electric current. Here he is asking the function, what is the main thing that a generator will do? First, reverses the direction of the current. This happens in both the cases, for electric generator as well as for motors. In both the cases, the direction of the current is reversed. Next, converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. See here, we all know that generator is used to produce current, or you can say to produce induced current. With the help of magnets, by rotating them, we are producing the current. So it is, this option B is not at all suitable. Here it is saying electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. No, this doesn't happen here. Instead, it happens in case of motors, where we plug in, due the passage or the flow of the current takes place through that plug, through that circuit, and then the motor starts working like a fan or water pump, like that. So this is for motor. And option A, this is possible for both motor and generator. Third, detects the presence of electric current in circuit. This is not at all suitable here, as it is for galvanometer. Galvanometer is used to detect the current here. Next, converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Just now I have explained, generators are the devices, the machines that have the capacity to convert mechanical energy of the strong magnets into the electrical energy. And that we will call as induced current. It is called as induced current. So this is how we come to the conclusion that among all four, option D is more suitable. Next, the resistance of a conductor does not depend on the resistance. He is asking R. It is not dependent upon. First, length of the conductor, that means what length, 1 meter, 2 meter, whatever the length of the wire we are using for the circuit. Second, area of cross section of the conductor, nothing but thickness. How thick the wire is? What is the diameter of that wire? Magnetic nature. This depends upon the nature of the material, the arrangement of the atoms in the material. And in magnetic effect of electric current, and also the chapter electricity, we haven't studied anything about the magnetic nature of the particles that shows the relation with resistance. So it appears to be a quite unsuitable option. Next, nature of the material. Yes, resistance depend upon the nature. For example, conducting materials, non-conducting, semiconducting materials, like that. So depending upon the nature of the material, whether it's a metal or non-metal, the resistance varies. And also we can relate it with the relation rho L by A, where resistance is dependent upon resistivity, nothing but nature of the material, directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area of cross section. So here we will conclude that option C is the answer on which the resistance does not depend. Next, we have the DC generator works on the principle of. Here it has asked about electric generator, its function. Here it is asking on what principle does it work. And we know that it is working on the principle that, or it is functioning, it is meant to convert mechanical energy into electrical energy, which is nothing but focusing on the production of induced current. So according to that, we'll see here electromagnetic induction. That means with the help of magnets, its rotation, we are producing the current, the same point that we have discussed here. Next one, magnetic effect of electric current. Here it is saying that with the help of electric current, we are producing the magnetic effect, but this happens in case of motors. Next, heating effect of electric current. No, heat is produced though, but it is not the principle on which a generator works. Chemical effect of electric current. That means whenever electric current is passed through a conductor, its chemical properties will change. This happens, but it is not the principle on which the generator is working. So we conclude that electromagnetic induction is the principle on which it is working.